The iPhone 13 Pro Max houses the largest battery cell in iPhone history, but unfortunately Apple have kept the same 20 watt charging capabilities as its predecessor, even though the battery capacity has jumped up by 665 milliamps, which means that it should take even longer to charge when compared to the 12 Pro Max. The two iPhones will be competing in this battery charge test alongside the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra, Huawei P50 Pro and Xiaomi Mix 4. The iPhone 13 Pro Max has a 4,352 mAh battery and supports up to 20 watt charging. I'll be using the official 20 watt Apple charger, which is sold separately. The iPhone 12 Pro Max has a significantly smaller battery at 3,687 mAh, which also supports the 20 watt Apple charger, which I'll be using today. The Galaxy S21 Ultra has the largest battery cell of the lot at a whopping 5,000 mAh and can charge up to 25 watts using the official Samsung Superfast charger, which is also sold separately. The Huawei P50 Pro has a 4,360 mAh battery capacity and utilizes 66 watt supercharged tech. And since the P50 Pro doesn't get bundled with a charger either, I'll be using the Honor Magic 3 Pro Plus's 66 watt block since it is the exact same charger. And last but not least, the Xiaomi Mix 4 has a 4,500 mAh battery and crazy 120 watt charging capabilities. And yes, Xiaomi includes the massive 120 watt charging brick in the box. I am extremely excited to get things going. This is Technic, and without further ado, let's go. Before we get things started, it is worth checking out the battery temperature at the start of the test while they're all currently unplugged and not plugged into charge. We will be comparing this during each time interval, and that time interval that you can see is in the top right hand corner and is in relation to the battery percentage above each phone and below the branding of that device. After the 5 minute mark interval, we have 8% on the iPhone 13 Pro Max, 3% on the 12 Pro Max, very strange over there, 9% on the S21 Ultra, 16% on the Huawei and 29% on the Mix 4. And I have also made sure to disable all forms of battery optimization on all devices, and super fast charging is indeed enabled on the S21 Ultra, with the coolest phone so far being the 12 Pro Max and hottest being the Xiaomi. After 10 minutes, we have 15% on the 13 Pro Max, 12% on the 12 Pro Max, no pun intended over there, 15% on the S21 Ultra, matching the 13 Pro Max, 29% on the Huawei, 52% on the Mix 4 after 10 minutes, which is crazy. Now 74% on the Mix 4 after just 15 minutes, 38% on the Huawei, 23% on the S21 Ultra and 13 Pro Max, and trailing the pack is the 20% on the 12 Pro Max, reaching that 20 minute mark interval, getting 31% on the iPhone 13 Pro Max, which has now exceeded the S21 Ultra's 29%, which is now matching the 12 Pro Max's 29%, 46%, almost 50% on the P50 Pro, and a whopping 86% on the Mix 4. The previous time I tested out the Mix 4, it actually did it in 21 minutes. Pretty strange to see that it's sitting at 90% after 25 minutes. And yes, it is still the hottest interval and peak in terms of temp, with the lowest interval temp being the S21 Ultra and the lowest peak temp being the P50 Pro. The Xiaomi does decide to say, hey, I'm first anyway, even though I charged slower than Nick's last test at just under 30 minutes over here, 30 minutes to be precise, with 3.33% per minute and 150 mAh per minute. Not too bad though. It did get pretty hot at around 50 degrees throughout the entire test. Its first 80% was at 19 minutes, which is fairly decent. But like I said, it did score 21 minutes the last time I decided to charge it up, but it is ridiculously hot here in Shanghai. After 45 minutes, we have 61% on the 13 Pro Max, matching the 12 Pro Max. Now 52% on the S21 Ultra, really lagging behind here, and 81% on the Huawei P50 Pro, with the P50 Pro now being the coolest in terms of interval temp and the lowest peak temp over here, doing a great job there, with the hottest interval temp being the 12 Pro Max, strangely enough. And the P50 Pro decides to clock out at just shy of 60 minutes, which is actually still pretty quick, though not quite as quick as the Huawei Mate 40 Pro that I tested out earlier on this year with a very similar sized battery cell and same wattage. We'll get to that a bit later. 79% on the iPhone after an hour and 1 minute on the 13 Pro Max. That is just 1% behind that, the 12 Pro Max. S21 Ultra at 69%, but now it has boosted all the way through to 84% once we hit that 1 hour and 15 mark interval, which is now matching the 13 Pro Max, and lagging behind this time is the 12 Pro Max with 82%. I have made sure, and it does say super fast charger connected to the S21 Ultra, and I have compared it to other tests. I've gotten just over an hour before for the S21 Ultra. My last test was an hour and 14 minutes. It's strange to see that after an hour and 30 minutes, it's still not done yet, sitting at 93% matching the 13 Pro Max. Though the 13 Pro Max, you got to remember, does have a much smaller battery than the Samsung, even though it has a weaker, well, less wattage block at 20 watts as opposed to the 25 watt block in the Samsung. The Samsung did finish charging. It said at the bottom of the always on display over there, at the 1 hour and 36 minute mark interval, which is not terrible, though not the fastest I've seen from the S21 Ultra. Still pretty decent with the lowest end temperature here amongst the three devices on the right hand side. After an hour and 45 minutes, 99% on the 13 Pro Max, 94% on the 12 Pro Max, and the 13 Pro Max finishes in 1 hour and 47 minutes, which seems okay for an iPhone with the largest battery ever seen in an iPhone. Pretty decent, ending off with a temperature of 35.8 degrees in Celsius and got a total milliamp hour per minute reading of 40.67, which is actually a bit better than previous iPhones I've tested out on my channel. 96% after 2 hours on the 12 Pro Max. Not quite sure what is going on here. As I showed multiple times throughout this test, battery optimizations is disabled on this iPhone, the iPhone beside it, and all other devices on the deck here. But like I mentioned as well, it is pretty hot here in Shanghai still, and there it is, optimized battery charging is disabled. 97% after 2 hours and 15 minutes is pretty ridiculous. And I have tested it out before at under the 2 hour mark interval, pretty similar in terms of time when compared to the 13 Pro Max at around an hour and a half or an hour and 45 minutes. And it's just not doing that, but it does finally clock off and Nick finally gets to take a rest after 2 hours and 32 minutes of charging up this big boy over here. And it is worth mentioning that the iPhone 13 Pro Max took 13 minutes to charge up its last 5%, whereas the iPhone 12 Pro Max took 42 minutes to charge up the last 5%. Fifth place over here, the iPhone 12 Pro Max, 0 to 100% using 20 watt charging in a 3,687 milliamp hour battery, doing it in 2 hours and 32 minutes, one of the longest charging devices ever on my channel. Fourth place is the iPhone 13 Pro Max, no surprise over here, an hour and 47 minutes, has a much larger battery at 4,352 milliamp hours, using the same charging wattage as the 12 Pro Max and did it quicker. The S21 Ultra in third place here with an hour and 36 minutes, though I have tested it out before and got just over an hour, massive 5,000 milliamp hour battery and 25 watt charging. Second place here, the Huawei P50 Pro, doing it in just under 60 minutes with 66 watt charging and a 4,360 milliamp hour battery, which is actually pretty impressive. But first place, very impressive, the Xiaomi Mix 4, doing it in 30 minutes with 120 watt charging and pretty decently sized 4,500 milliamp hour battery, though I have done the same test and gotten a score of 21 minutes. And when comparing these devices to their previous charge tests on my channel, the 12 Pro Max did it in an hour and 50 minutes last time I tested it, which was around 3 months ago, which is a hell of a lot better than the 2 hours and 32 minutes we got today. In that same test, which actually went against the Xperia 1 Mark III, was the S21 Ultra, which did it in an hour and 14 minutes. And since I haven't charged the P50 Pro on my channel yet, it is worth comparing it to Huawei's last flagship device, that being the Mate 40 Pro, with a slightly larger battery, but same 66 watt charging, doing it in 57 minutes. So I guess you could say it's pretty consistent. And lastly, the Xiaomi Mix 4, which is probably the biggest disappointment over here, did it in 21 minutes last time out. But you've got to remember that in that test, I actually started it from 1 to 100%. This time we did it from 0 to 100%. So I guess Xiaomi took 9 minutes to go from 0 to 1%. I'm not too sure. I don't think that actually happened. Nevertheless, like I mentioned throughout the test, it was pretty hot when I decided to charge these devices up, but I did make sure to crank the AC up and keep the ventilation flowing through my household. Guys, I hope that you thoroughly enjoyed watching this video as much as I did making it. This is TechNick, and I'll catch you in the next one.